back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
In Irish lore, the Tuatha De Danann took revenge upon the mill by blighting wheat crops and spoiling milk. When Christian elements entered fairy lore, it became customary to dip a thumb in fresh milk and make the sign of the cross to ward off fairies. If a person insults or displeases fairies, they have the power to transform him into a beast, a stone, or something else in nature. Bewitched and fairy-possessed people and animals, who act strangely, sicken, or fall into trances or even seizures, are called fairy struck and elf shot. The latter term refers to invisible arrows shot into people and animals. Fairies teach witches their magical lore and casting of spells. Changelings. Fairies are well known for stealing human babies and substituting their own ugly babies in their place. The taking happens at night when a child is asleep or when it is napping unattended. Evans Wentz gives the following quoted oral account from France, about a woman and her three children, as an example. When she had her first child, a very strong and very pretty boy, she noticed one morning that he had been changed during the night. There was no longer the fine baby that she had put to bed in the evening. There was, instead, an infant hideous to look at, greatly deformed, hunchbacked, and crooked, and of a black color. The poor woman knew that a fairy had changed her child. This changed infant still lives, and today he is about 70 years old. He has all the possible vices, and he has tried many times to kill his mother. He is a veritable demon, he predicts the future, and has a habit of running abroad at night. They call him the Little Corrigan, a type of fairy, and everybody flees from him. Being poor and infirm now, he is obliged to beg, and people give him alms because they have a great fear of him. His nickname is Olier. The woman had two other children, who also were said to be normal at birth but were stolen by the fairies and also became demonic hunchbacks. Then she was advised by a wise woman to put a sprig of boxwood blessed by a priest in the cradle, and the fairies would be repelled. She did so for her fourth child, and it was not affected. The idea of changelings might have explained problems in infants that were not apparent at birth but developed later, and even crib death, or sudden infant death syndrome, SIDS. The affected infants were not unrecognizable or completely different, but they were changed for the worse in noticeable ways. Possession and exorcism. Changelings result from possession. An entity steals a soul during sleep. The changelings were thus fairy possessed. As the preceding account shows, a changeling had demonic characteristics much as a person possessed by a demon does, an altered personality, evil tendencies and acts, supernormal abilities, prophecy, and an altered physical appearance. The hunchback is even called a veritable demon. In the case of changelings, the possession was usually permanent. Exorcism remedies exist in fairy lore. How effective they were probably depended on the nature of the problem affecting the infant. One remedy in French lore, for example, was to leave a changeling outdoors. The fairies would hear it cry and take it back, leaving the true child in its rightful place. Fairies were well known for bewitching milk, and exorcisms of milk once were common in folklore practices. The vessel for containing the milk was exorcised and blessed, and so was the milk poured into it. Demons as well as fairies possessed milk, sometimes little or no distinction was made between one and the other. The biography of the Irish patron Saint Columba, who lived in the 6th century, tells a story about the saint's exorcism of milk. The Vita Columbae was written by Adamnan, the abbot of Iona. One day a youth named Columban did the milking and took the pail to Saint Columba for exorcism. The saint made the sign of the cross in the air, but the lid flew off and most of the milk spilled. Columba said, "Thou hast done carelessly in thy work today, for thou hast not cast out the demon that was lurking in the bottom of the empty pail, by tracing on it, before pouring in the milk, the sign of the Lord's cross, and now not enduring, thou seest, the virtue of the sign, he has quickly fled away in terror, while at the same time the whole of the vessel has been violently shaken, and the milk spilled." Columba then ordered a half-full pail to be carried to him for exorcism. When he blessed it, the pail miraculously filled with milk. One old folk custom in Brittany, France, called for the burning of green branches on the summer solstice. Domestic farm animals were passed through the smoke, which exorcised all evil spirits and fairies and protected them from bewitchment and possession. In the case of cows, it especially guaranteed the abundant supply of milk. Fairies in contemporary lore. Since Victorian times, fairies have been increasingly stripped of their formidable powers and trivialized as little beings with wings, or female ballerina-like figures with wands. The fictitious Tinkerbell, created by the Scottish novelist J.M. Barrie around the turn of the 20th century as part of the Peter Pan stories, also added to the degrading of fairies to inconsequential, little creatures. The continuing portrayal of fairies in popular media is of cute, magical little beings with no demonic associations. The Tooth Fairy, who leaves money in exchange for teeth left underneath a pillow, is still popular with small children.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.